A special Akwa Aba once again to you all, Sis family. If it's your first time here, my name is Cynthia and I upload cooking and fashion videos on this platform. On our menu today is flour chips, popularly known as chin chin, and this is one of the best snacks you can enjoy with cold or warm beverage. The ingredients are 6 cups of flour, which is all-purpose flour, 250 milliliters of evaporated milk, 1 stick unsalted butter, which is approximately 120 grams, 100 grams of sugar, 1.5 cups of needle, 2 eggs, 1/2 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 tablespoon of cinnamon, 1 tablespoon of nutmeg, and 500 milliliters of water. For your convenience, I will leave the list of ingredients and the measurements in the description box. The process of this flour chips recipe is quite simple. You can mix the wet and dry ingredients manually with your hands. I have a video on that and I will paste it in the description box. If you have a food processor, that will make life easier. All you need to do is to load the ingredients into your food processor and run it till the ingredients turns into a dough. It took me just 30 seconds to achieve this with my Ninja food processor. Lovelies, if you have a food processor, please use it as it makes life so easy. You can see that I'm spreading some flour on the pastry mat. This is just to prevent the dough from sticking on the mat. This your salad. It tastes so sweet. I love it. Sis kitchen. Pepe dani papa, ifa na menyano. Sis kitchen. Pepe dani yede, ifa na menyano. Sis kitchen. This stage, I will mold the dough and divide it into sizes that I can work with, and afterwards put it in the refrigerator between 40 minutes to an hour. This is just to make the chips crunchy.
Salad, this food is delicious. Sweet aroma, so tasty.
You can also omit the refrigeration and go ahead with the rolling and cutting. The choice is entirely up to you. I am going to roll the dough out and cut it into my preferred shapes.
Salad, yeah, 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 yeah
There are so many ways you can cut your chips. You can use the pizza cutter, scissors or pastry cutter, and you are good to go. It is advisable to sprinkle flour on the dough to prevent the pieces from sticking together.
I love it.
Here we are with my three different shapes. You can be a bit artistic and cut it into any shape of your choice. The choice is always up to you. Now you can start by preheating your oil to 150 degrees on a high heat. When you are about to fry the chips, please remember to turn your heat down to medium heat throughout the frying process to ensure a perfect fry. To avoid the chips from burning, please continue to stir continuously, and you will know it's ready when the chips turn into golden brown. I lined my tray with kitchen towel to soak up the excess oil. You can also use a strainer to let the excess oil drip out. Our chips is ready, and I chose to serve it with roasted almonds and roasted peanuts. Trust me, they taste really nice. This will be a perfect choice of snack for the family, especially now that the kids are on summer break from school. I hope this video has been useful. If you enjoyed it, please kindly give it a thumbs up and share. If you are new here, welcome to Sis Kitchen. It's a pleasure having you here today. Please subscribe and join this amazing family. Thank you so much for your support. See you all in my next video. Please stay safe. God bless you, and bye for now.